Yes. Hello dear friends, how are you? In this video series, I want to give you the basic, some fundamental formulas about the ship stability. Because I am receiving some messages from YouTube and WhatsApp, some questions. So I observe that there are some problem with the basic formulas of the ship stability and the basic fundamental things in the basic. There are some problems. So I want to make a video about this one. Okay, from the beginning, actually. These formulas are in Turkish language, but I will translate it. It is no problem. Actually, mathematical formulas. You see, this stability formula notları means the formulas of stability notes. Okay, only the formulas. So I just made a page like this when I was student at the faculty. Okay, this is my own notes from the faculty. So I collect all the formulas in the stability lesson in one page. So I also recommend you just take a small notebook during your seaman life. Okay. Keep this one with you. When you learn something, some critical things or the basic things like this, always write this notebook and in every vessel bring that notebook. Okay. And one of the other thing, important thing, dear friends, you can find any formula, anything, any books, okay, from anywhere. But your own notes in the faculty, you cannot find anywhere. So when you finish faculty, until you finish your sea life, always keep that notes from the faculty. Never throw your notes, okay, own notes, because you cannot find anymore. If you throw them, okay, it is very very important. So always keep these notes about 15 years, 16 year notes. Okay. So, özgül ağırlık means specific gravity. Specific gravity is the density of the thing divided density of the water. For example, what we mean with that one, for example, seawater actually specific gravity of the seawater. Okay, so what we are doing, what is the density of the seawater? 1025. So we divide this one 1, so it is 1025, for example. This is specific gravity, the density of something divided by density of the water. Okay. This is specific gravity. Other thing, the rough changing quantity. For example, if I say the changing quantity is theta, okay. The rough changing quantity, if it's theta, this is the formula. Fresh water allowance multiply with the sea water density minus the density divided by 25. This 25 is fixed, okay. Don't forget this one. So, what does it mean? You know, for example, I open from here. What we mean with the draft change? Okay, can I turn this page, rotate here, anything? How can we do this one? Pardon. Pardon. Anything else? Fetch, yes. What is this? Rotate sayfayı hazır. Yes. Anyway, okay. So I will download one of the PDF viewer. This is refresh, yes. Not rotate. Anyway, this is the film hallmark, correct? So I draw here. This is the film hallmark. This is the center line. Here is zone letters, correct? So I draw here like this. For example, this is summer. This is fresh water. So what we mean with the draw change? With the draw change. So this is summer, correct? This is fresh water. So when we are making, for example, we are in the salty water, summer, and we are proceeding to fresh water, correct? So this is the draft change. Okay. So we can calculate this one with this formula. But what is important, don't forget, this is not only from summer to fresh water, correct? This is also you can write density 1 minus density 2. For example, if you are navigating in intermediate densities, for example, brackish water, if you are going from 1015 to 1010, for example, so it is better to write density 1 minus density 2. It is always better. Not only for seawater to any other density, or not only for the seawater to fresh water density. You can write density 1 minus density 2. For example, 1020 minus 1012. Something like this. Any density you can write here. Okay. So this plus minus. For example, you are going from 1010 to 1020. So it will be minus. Correct. So it mean your draft will reduce. Why? Because you are going to 10.10 to 10.20. Correct. So the density of the water is higher. So your vessel will increase. Okay. This is the basic formula we are using. Also, I erase this one. Okay. This is the formula of the fresh water allowance. Okay. Fresh water allowance. You know, in the school, always we are calculating this one in millimeter. So, displacement divided by 4 multiply with the TPC. Correct. But what I recommend you in the vessel, in the practice, we are making all the calculations in centimeter. So instead of 4, you divide with 40. So displacement divided 40 multiply with the TPC, giving you fresh water allowance. So we are using this fresh water allowance for the calculating draft change. Don't forget, this 25 is fixed. So here, I cannot rotate this page really. Anyway, so also I want to tell one more important thing. Okay, here Don't forget my friend. This one, the center of this circle. You see, this white area is bigger than this white area. Correct. Because the lines center is always top. Don't forget. For example, what you mean with the sour, not the down, not the, oh, I make this one just a moment, just more bigger. This will be much more bigger. Yes. Okay. Not the center of the line. Not like this. Also not the down. Always up. Up limit. Okay, up limit. Here, fresh water also. You see this fresh water. Also, the center of the summer, the film soil mark is up. Don't forget this one. So, distance here is, you see fresh water allowance. From summer to top of the fresh water. Correct. So it is 288. What does it mean in millimeter? But normally we are using in centimeter. So 28.8 centimeter. So what I recommend you in this formula, instead of 4, you just use 40. Okay. So you can directly calculate in centimeter. Also fresh water allowance here using centimeter. So the result, the rough change, the quantity of the rough change will be directly in centimeter. Okay. So this is the center of gravity change. Okay. Formula of center of gravity. This is only for single weight. So for example, when you put a weight on vessel, so how will the center of gravity will shift? This is the shifting of the center of gravity. Okay, in meter. So weight is weight W, multiply with the distance, divided by displacement. But this distance from where? This distance from the center of gravity of the vessel. Okay, don't forget this one. For example, also I want to draw some fundamental things of the vessel. For example, how I draw with this one. Yes. Okay, this is my vessel. For example, this is my superstructure. Correct. Like this. For example, I change the color. I think red is better. My friend, for example, this is my center of gravity. Okay. So, here I change this one. For example, I put some weight on my deck. Correct. Additional weight I put on deck. For example, I am carrying project cargo. So I put one heavy part like this on my deck. So what is the center of gravity of this thing? Is this one correct? So in the beginning, my vessel center of gravity is that one. But I put some additional weight here. So my center of gravity will little shift around here. Correct? Huh. This is the formula for that one. Okay. So the shift, the distance, the change in the center of gravity. How many meter, how many centimeter it will change. If you use this distance centimeter, it will give you centimeter. If you use meter, it will give you meter. But how I calculate total kg of the vessel? Because one of the friend asked me how we calculate the keel to gravity, kg of the vessel. What is kg of the vessel? Displacement multiply with the, for example, we say this one, light ship, multiply with the kg of the light ship, plus any weight in the tanks, total ballast, multiply with the kg. İşte fuel oil, multiply with the kg. All I am writing like this, divide Light ship all the weights. Okay. So it is giving me the key G. So what I want to tell also, what is key G? What is B? What is LCF? I want to draw here also. Okay. Some fundamental things. My friend. For example. This is my vessel. Correct. Lights. And here the water line. Okay. Nerede? Yes. Ha. Şimdi center of gravity is the all the weights total center of the gravity. For example, how can we say actually? All the geographical center of the weights all on board. Okay. For example, here is the G point, center of gravity. What is center of buoyancy? Center of buoyancy, you see, this is the water line. And under side of this water line, there is a volume here. For example, it is like this, correct? Vessel is like this. It is going like this. Some volume, underside of the water. The geographical center of this volume is the buoyancy center. What does it mean, buoyancy center? This is the B. Buoyancy center, the water apply rising force. Okay. From the gravity center, vessel's weight try to sink in the water. Correct. What is floating center? This is the water line. And this is the water line area. Correct here. This area. Correct. This surface. Only this surface. I cut the vessel from the water line exactly. I assume like this. This in this surface. The geographical geometrical center of this area, not the volume. Only the water line surface. Okay. Geometrical center is the floating center. Okay. For example, here. So, what is floating center? We assume vessel is moving around this one. How moving? For example, buoyancy from the sea try to rise the vessel. Vessel is with his own weight try to sink. So this is the moving point. So from here vessel is rising, from here vessel try to sink. So my vessel trim, for example, to stern trim. Correct, because I am rising here, I am pulling down here. So the vessel, I assume that vessel moving in that area, in that point, floating point. So, pardon. If it is a wooden stick, I put something here. I am pulling down here and I am rising there. So it will move. It will rotate, correct? Like this. Like this. Like this. Correct. So same for the vessel. Okay. So I also want to draw one more thing here. Şunu çizelim. This is my vessel. Correct. This is superstructure, something coming like this. Okay. This is the funnel, something işte. Main mast, something. Okay. Şimdi this is the kill point. Key. For example, this is the water line. Correct. For example, here is the gravity center. G. For example, işte here is buoyancy center. For example, just for example, B. This is floating center. And for example, here is the meta center. Okay. So this line Okay, so this is gravity point, buoyancy point, and metacenter height. So this is the key. This is the key G. This is the key B. This is the GM. Correct. The distance between them. So also when we see vessel from the side, I draw again here like this. This is the water line. So don't forget this one in ship stability books. Some of them, I just erased this one, I didn't like. In ship stability books, they give the calculations from two points. The first point is from the midship. Okay. The other point is the base frame from the aft, for example. So if you give, for example, this is the buoyancy center, this is the gravity center, this is the floating center. Okay. This is G, this is B, this is F, correct. So in some of the books they give you, for example, -9. What does it mean, -9? From midship it is forward 9 meters. For example, here -11, so this distance from midship is 11 meters. For example, here is plus 2.5, for example. So this distance from midship is 2.5 meters. So plus minus means minus is the forward part of the midship, plus means the aft part of the midship. But you, I have already think about this one. When you go any vessel, please check the list of abbreviations. Okay, in the ship stability books. So in here written, sometimes because port side plus starboard minus, some of the vessels port side minus, starboard side plus, some vessels forward part plus, aft part minus. So some vessels forward minus, aft plus. So it can be opposite. So you have to know about the signs. How will you know? You will check the in ship stability booklet list of abbreviations. Okay. But for example, in some of the vessel they assume the base frame is the, for example, aft frame. So what I mean, normally what is this distance? LCB, correct, longitudinal center of buoyancy. What is this distance? This distance LCG, longitudinal center of gravity. LCF, longitudinal center of floating center. Correct. But sometimes they give you LCB from the aft, this distance, correct? This distance LCB. They give you only one thing, not plus minus something. So it's mean, and if it is big digits, for example, because if I assume my LBP is 200 meter, so what is the aft part? 100 meter, forward part 100 meter. So this distance 100 plus what we tell, for example, 9 meter. So if it is 109 meter from the aft, LCB is 109. For example, here I told plus 11. So if you, this distance is 100, I minus 11 meter, so 89 meter. So my LCG, correct, will be 89. What will be my LCF? This distance is from the base frame, frame 0. What is base frame? Frame 0. They, when they are making calculations, they assume, for example, aft perpendicular pin is 0. Okay, the or the heel pin, for example, is 0 frame. So for example, what is the distance? 100 minus 2.5, işte 98.5 meter from the aft. So how I will convert this one? if you don't know, and if you confuse the calculations, what is my total length? LBP, LBP. For example, 200. Okay, 200 meters. Yeah, I am sorry for the mouse. It is really very bad. Anyway, so the half is 100 meter. The forward part is 100 meter. So total LBP, not length overall. Okay, LBP is 100. So I can convert if this is 100. If my, for example, LCF is, or just take the G point, LCG is, for example, 11 meter. So I can calculate it will be 89 meter or 11 meter from the stern. For example, buoyancy center 9 meter forward of the midship. It signs minus. So 100 from here, 9 meter from here. So total 109 meter will be my LCB. Okay. Also, what I want to tell. For example, you see this height keel to gravity center. So what we tell this one, KG. KG is same is vertical center of gravity. This is longitudinal center of gravity. This is vertical center of gravity. It is same with the KG. Because in some of the vessels they write KG, some of the vessels they write vertical center of gravity, VGG. Okay. So this is another thing I want to tell. I think it is clear. If any questions, something you can write also, you can ask also. Okay. In my YouTube page, in about section, I have my WhatsApp number here, so you can ask. Also, I want to show about this one. Any drawing? Yes, here. You see, this is another drawing. This is keel point, this is buoyancy center, this is gravity center, this is floating center, and this is mastery point. Okay. All the GM, GZ, everything coming from these triangles. Okay. Neyse, I will explain this one. Anyway, we just continue. What is this? Okay, I already explained. And then I come here. What is this? This is rolling period. Okay. Rolling period in second. So, this is formula is fixed. Don't forget this one. This 0.89 and 0.44 is fixed, not change. Okay. And then what is my GM? Square of this GM. Okay. I write here. And my breadth of the vessel, okay. Breadth molded. For example, let's say 32 meter. Okay, I write here 32 meter. So, this is fixed. I write my breadth of the vessel also in the, this GM. Yeah, I forgot the English term of this sign, but this is the opposite sign of the square, okay. So, actually, if I write 4, if I take this one, it's mean 2. Correct, huh? This one. So, but when I am using which one? So, if I want to calculate in meter, I use this 0.82. If I want to calculate from the feet, so I use 0.44. But the result all same in second. What is this rolling period? Okay. And then this is forward and aft period, yani pitching period. Okay. So also TP, pitching, rolling. Okay. So TP is 1 divided 2, also same in that sign. Also this LBP. Okay, this is fixed. You can calculate only one time. Okay, LBP is fixed. For example, let's say 200. Okay, I write this one in 200 and divide to 2, giving my pitching period. So, what does it mean? I have already here. Okay. So, residual dynamic stability area. Okay, so what does it mean? This is the writing arm moment. Okay, how I calculate writing arm? Displacement multiply with the GM multiply with the sinus theta. So, before here I come here. What is GM? I have already show here. Okay, from this gravity center to mastery point. This distance is the GM. Okay, this is the writing arm. Okay, I also erase this one. Okay. So GM, I have already explained. We have two kind of mastery point calculation in the grain booklets. Okay. One of these. This one, the KM curves. Okay. KM curves. The others, GM curves. How we are calculating? GZ curves and KM curves. Okay. How we are calculating? If, for example, nowadays they are always using this KM curves. What is KM curves? They are assuming this metacenter height, calculating directly from the keel. Okay. This one. KM, you are using from this from the stability booklet. The shipyard directly give you this one. But this KG, you are calculating from here. All the total weights, one by one, each of them multiply with their center of gravity, but vertical center of gravity, divided the total displacement, giving you the vessel's KG. Okay. So, if I minus from the keel to mastery point, minus keel to gravity center, from keel to mastery point, here, keel to mastery point, minus keel to gravity center, giving me that distance, correct? This distance is GM. Okay, so I am using this one when calculating the GM. GZ, writing arm. How we are calculating? GM multiply with the sinus theta. Theta is which? Theta, this one. When vessel list one side. Okay. If I may, pardon. Yeah, I am waiting for the graphic pad actually. I am very sorry for the writings because with the mouse it is very very difficult to write. Okay. When vessel list one side, this is the C line. Okay. And my vessel list one side. So which angle in the theta angle? All of them same. Theta angle here. Theta angle here. So these triangles. Okay. This triangle I transfer here, giving me that formulas. Okay. So GZ, writing arm, GM multiply sinus theta, GZ KN minus KG sinus theta, KN KM kill to mastery multiply with the sinus theta. What is KN? KN this part. Yeah, this is the shifting of the things. Gravity center same, but buoyancy center, because in the beginning my underwater volume, correct, is that area, but now my vessel list and the shape change, correct, becoming like this. This area become this area. So buoyancy center was in the center. Now shift the Geometric center of that shape. Correct. This one. In the beginning, it was exactly center because my vessel was upright. So, and this killed the shifting, but this must be parallel, okay? This one and this one. So I connect this one with the master point. I find N point. And then this is the theta. Healing angle, listing angle, whatever you say. So this simple triangle giving me this calculation formulas. Okay. So I come here. So GZ is equal GM multiplies sin theta. But this formula you can use up to 10-15 degrees list. If your vessel list more than 15 degree, you have to use that formula. Okay. GM plus 1 divided to BM multiply tangent square theta and all of them multiply with the sin theta. If your healing angle list is more than 15 degree. Okay. But if it is less than 15 degree, okay, directly use that formula. And then how we calculate GZ. So what I told you, there are two kind when you are calculating. How we will calculate GZ? In the stability booklets, they give you two kind of curves. One of them KN curves, one of them GZ curves. What is KN curves? From keel to N. But this is zero. So KM multiply with the sin theta. I always this one. But in the GZ curves, for example, they assume the beginning point of this, for example, from the 5 meter. Okay, 5 meter. So, what is my KG? If my KG is bigger than assumed G, so I use minus in here. Okay, GZ is equal GZ plus minus change of the gravity multiply with the sin theta. If my assumed G is bigger than my key G, so is smaller than, I use plus. Okay, I repeat again. If it is bigger, my key G is bigger than assumed G, minus. My key G is smaller than assumed G, I use plus. But my friends, in today, they don't use this one. This is for very, very old vessels, okay? But anyway, in the school, maybe for the exams, they can ask you. But in vessel, what we are using? We are directly using that GZ curves, okay? We are calculating GZ, KN. Where I am finding this one? I find KM from the stability booklet. Okay. And then multiply with sinus theta. I find KN. And KN minus KG multiply sin theta. I find GZ. Okay. When in, for example, grain calculations. So, my friends, I already finished this Japanese vessels, Chinese vessels with Australian calculation and Canadian calculation forms. After this fundamental basic info, I will make a video about grain calculation for USA with Korean vessel. Okay. So we will repeat again this one more time. Also in this video, I am planning to explain one example. Okay. And then we come here. I already explained. This is rolling period. This is pitching period. And this is righting arm. Displacement multiply GM multiply sin theta. And this is for how can I say, manual calculation for reducing GM by free surface moment. Okay, so normally what we are doing, we are opening manual sounding booklet. we are finding inertia moment, and then we multiply this one with the specific gravity of the liquid inside the tank, and we find free surface moment, correct, directly like this. But yeah, this formula actually we are not using on board, but maybe in the school they just ask if they assume this is a tank, any tank, okay, like this, in that shape, like this, correct. I erase this one, şöyle, okay, this is any tank. So in that tank, some liquid we have, okay, like this, some liquid. So how I will calculate this free surface moment? This formula give you manual calculation part for this one. So what is this? I is the inertia moment, okay, of the liquid inside the tank. Volume. So this is the volume of the vessel underside of the water, okay, not the tank, not the liquid inside, all the vessels underside volume, okay. And then D1, the density one, this is the density of the water inside the tank. This is density 2, density of the sea water, okay. And this is the from side to side, from port side to starboard side, how many tank we are calculating. I draw here only one, but maybe it is 2, 3, 4, how many tank you are calculating. L is the length of the tank, okay. B, the breadth of the tank, okay, width of the tank. And then this is the formula. I divided V multiply density 1, density 1 divided density 2 multiply 1 divided square N. And what is I? So I am calculating I. What was the I? I, the free surface inertia moment. Inertia moment of the liquid inside the tank. So L, length, multiply with the breadth of the tank, divided 12. And volume, what is the volume? Displacement. How we will calculate the underside volume of the vessel? Okay. How we will calculate underside volume of the vessel? So total displacement divided the sea water density. Yeah, they write here 1.025, but if you are swimming in, for example, 1.010, so it must be the density 1.010, okay, current density. So this is manual calculation formula, but this is only for the school exams, okay. What is the actual formula for the free surface moment? Actual formula, this one. What is this? This is the inertia moment, okay. When you open the book, they write EMOM, correct. In the manual sounding booklets, they write something like this, or sometimes they write E4. Okay, E4. This means inertia moment. You multiply this one with the density of the water inside the tank. For example, if it is fresh water tank, it is 1. If it is seawater, 1.25. For example, if it is fuel oil, 0.85. For example, if it is diesel oil, 0.980, something like this. Okay, whatever inside, or anything, any lubricating oil, anything, no problem. What is the density of the water inside the tank? Or we write here specific gravity of the fluid inside the tank. Okay, specific gravity multiply with the inertia moment giving you free surface moment. Don't forget, you find this one, EMOM, or E4, I4 is not directly free surface moment. You have to, when you find inertia moment in the manual sounding booklet, you must multiply with the specific gravity and this give you free surface moment. Okay. So how we are calculating reducing in the GM with that formula. Reducing in the GM is total free surface moment divided by displacement. Okay. And then one another. Okay, this is 45 minutes. I cut this video here. We continue with the next one. Thank you for watching.